Have you ever wondered how real traffic lights work? What if you could build your mini version at home using just a 555 timer? Hey guys, in this video, you'll learn step by step how to create a realistic traffic light circuit that switches green, yellow, and red, just like the ones on the road. Stay tuned to the second part of this video, where I'll explain how this circuit works. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. 13 jumper wires, one 100,000 ohm resistor, one 47,000 ohm resistor, two 330 ohm resistors, one 470 ohm resistor, two 100 microfarad capacitors, three LEDs, one 9-volt battery, one 9-volt battery buckle connector, two 555 timer ICs, a breadboard to connect everything together. The 555 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Pin 1, located at the top left, serves as the ground or ground supply. Pin 2, the trigger pin, initiates the timing interval in monostable and astable modes. Pin 3 serves as the output, providing the timer's operational result depending on its mode: monostable, astable, or bistable. Pin 4, the reset pin, is used to reset the 555 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 serves as the control pin, enabling you to adjust the threshold voltage levels used by the internal comparators to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6, the threshold pin, monitors the voltage of the capacitor in the circuit. Pin 7, the discharge pin, manages the timing capacitor's charge and discharge cycle. Pin 8, known as VCC, supplies power to the IC. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Begin by positioning the 555 timer IC on the breadboard. The pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left corner. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have questions about the circuit connections. Insert the 555 timer in the middle of the breadboard. Insert another 555 timer below the first one. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 or trigger to pin 6 or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. Insert a jumper wire into pin 3 or output of the first 555 timer and pin 8 or VCC of the second one. Bend the ends of a 100,000 ohm resistor. Insert the 100,000 ohm resistor into pin 3 or output and pin 6 or threshold. Insert a jumper wire into pin 1 or ground and the negative rail of the second 555. Insert a jumper wire into pin 2 or trigger in pin 6 or threshold. Insert a jumper wire into pin 4 or reset and the positive rail. Bend the ends of a 47,000 ohm resistor. Insert the 47,000 ohm resistor into pin 3 or output and pin 6 or threshold. Insert a 100 microfarad capacitor into pin 2 or trigger in the negative rail. The positive lead is in pin 2. Insert another 100 microfarad capacitor into pin 2 of the second 555 and the negative rail. insert a jumper wire into pin 3 or output of the second 555 and a few rows below it. Insert a green LED below the jumper wire. The positive lead is in the same row as the jumper wire. Bend the ends of a 330 ohm resistor. Insert the 330 ohm resistor into the same row as the LED and the negative rail. Bend the ends of a 470 ohm resistor. Insert the 470 ohm resistor into pin 7, or discharge of the second 555 and a few rows below it. Insert a jumper wire in the same row as the resistor and a few rows below it. Insert a yellow LED in the same row as the jumper wire. The negative lead is in the same row as the jumper wire. Insert a jumper wire in the same row as the yellow LED and the positive rail. Insert a jumper wire into pin 3 or output of the first 555 and a few rows below the second one. Bend the ends of a 330 ohm resistor. Insert the 330 ohm resistor into the same row as the jumper wire and one row above the yellow LED. Insert a red LED in the same row as the resistor. The negative lead is in the same row as the resistor. Use a jumper wire to connect the positive rails together. Connect the buckle connector to the 9-volt battery. It's time to connect the power supply. Insert the positive lead to the positive rail. Insert the negative lead to the negative rail. We have successfully completed the circuit. As you can see, the LED switches from green to yellow to red. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. This traffic light circuit uses two 555 timer ICs configured in a stable mode to create a simple sequence that mimics real traffic lights, transitioning from green to yellow to red. The right 555 timer controls the green LED. It oscillates with a timing cycle set by a 47,000 ohm resistor and a 100 microfarad capacitor. When its output, or pin 3, goes high, current flows through a 330 ohm resistor to the green LED, turning it on. After a set duration, the timer output goes low, turning off the green LED and triggering the transition to the yellow phase. The output from the green timer feeds into the input of the left 555 timer, which controls both the yellow and red LEDs. This second timer also runs in a stable mode, with its timing determined by a 100,000 ohm resistor and a 100 microfarad capacitor. When its output goes high, the yellow LED turns on briefly through a 470 ohm resistor, simulating a caution phase. After this, the red LED lights up through a 330 ohm resistor, remaining on for a longer duration. This cycle, green to yellow to red, then repeats, just like a real traffic signal. Powered by a 9-volt battery, it's a great project for learning about sequencing, timing, and using 555 timers in real-world applications. I hope this video has shown you how to make a traffic light circuit with a 555 timer. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.